Hi friends, I'm Kat, and today I'm going to show you how to train forest models in SAS. There are lots of ways, really, that you can train forest models in SAS, and the one I'm going to show you today uses SAS Viya. Actually, I'm going to show you two ways in SAS Viya, but there's even more than that, because if you like to program, you can program with procedures, you can program it in Python or R, and still run it on SAS Viya. You can use point-and-click methods. I'm going to show you two of those point-and-click methods today. So a little bit about forests. Forest models combine lots of decision trees or regression trees together. And in a forest, what you use is a random sampling of the data to introduce stochastic variation into those trees. And then you assign a composite score to each observation across the trees in the forest. That composite score might be an average of all the scores from the different trees in the forest, or it might be based on a vote across predictions or other metrics. But really, it's just what it sounds like. A forest has lots and lots of trees. So before you get stuck not being able to see the forest for the trees, I'm going to show you how to create a forest model. Right now, I am in Visual Statistics, Visual Analytics, and in Visual Analytics, there is a set of tasks called SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning. These are interactive tasks for training machine learning models that lets you fit them really, really quickly and be able to look interactively at what's going on in the results as you go. I'm going to double click the forest task. And the data set I'm using today is called VS Bank Part. It's a partition data set with some marketing information about customers for a large bank who are acquiring a new product or a new account type. And I'm going to use as inputs for my decision trees, in other words, for the forest, each tree is going to be splitting on input variables that you see here, log I, RFM 1 through 12. And for all of these, easiest way is to just highlight all of them and drop them in to my forest like this. Under roles, those get put in as a mix of predictors, and one of them got put in as the response. So I want to make sure I take that one out and make sure that it is assigned. So come on, make sure I get all the variables that I actually want into the analysis. It still doesn't have an analysis because I haven't assigned a response. Oh, and there are other predictors I want to use. There are a few categorical predictors here that I find especially helpful. One of them is the Category 1 account activity level, and the other one is the Category 2 customer value level. So I'm going to go ahead and put those in there and have those included. I also like to use a partition variable when I can, because then it can use that partition variable for things like comparing validation or training data, tuning the model. But look, it says I don't have a partition. This is a question we get all the time. How do I point at my partition variable if I already have a partition variable? And here's one thing I wanted to make sure to show you. So we have a partition indicator in the data set. You can see it right there. It says partition indicator. But I have to be able to tell Visual Analytics that this is a partition variable. Okay? So I'm going to have this based on a data item called the partition indicator. The training value is the validation value is validation. The training value is training. Click OK. Now it's been assigned correctly. And now it's available in my list. So there it is, your little tidbit for the day. I'm going to pick partition indicator. And then I'm going to assign a response. What is the response variable? It's going to be a binary target. Here's one more place where we get a lot of questions. And I guess I could run it and show it to you. But right now, you see that little ruler on the side? That means that this variable is a measure. It's a numeric. It's just zeros and ones. So it would try to fit a bunch of regression trees to the 0-1 response. That's not quite what I want. So one more place you need to be sure that you let Visual Analytics know what you want to do with your data. So I'm going to right click and convert that to a category. Now that it's a category up here in my list, If I put it into the response, it will treat it as a category and it will use classification trees instead of regression trees. And now it's developing that model. It's going to give me my random forest. Let's see what options are being used. The default is to develop a model with 100 trees, to do bootstrap sampling of 60% of the data at each tree. So what that means is each time it develops a new tree, it takes a sample with replacement of 60% of the training data, uses that to develop the tree, and then that's the in-bag data set, and then there's the out-of-bag data set, which is the remaining 40% that didn't go in. So all of the observations in the bag are called training, and then the out-of-bag are the ones that from the training data set did not go in from the bootstrap sample. The way that it's assigning an observation to a class level can be done by a majority, which is the voting, or by a probability. I'm going to change this to use a probability. We can also change the splitting criteria on each of the trees. And if you watch some of our videos on decision trees, you'll see lots of different ways that you can choose how to split a tree. So while this is running, we're going to come down and take a look at some of the other options. If you're familiar with decision trees, you'll know that trees can use missing values as part of the split search, or you could impute your values first. So there are different things you might want to do with missing data. In this case, we've already imputed missing values, so we don't need to do anything with them. But use and search is actually a good choice if you've got missing data, because if there's any systematic relationship between missingness and the target variable, it can capture that by finding that, oh, you get a better split if you put all the missing values in branch left or something of that sort. We can also set limits on the size of the trees and a little bit about the assessment and so on. You can see here with our 100 trees, it's still pretty bumpy out here at the end. That would tell me I should probably grow more trees. So see how this is still kind of bumpy? I'd like to see this really level off. So maybe I'm going to tell it that I want more trees. This will take a little longer to run, but I'm going to tell it that I want 150 trees this time. And what is it doing? It's doing bootstrap sampling, 60% for each tree, and then it creates a tree. The remaining 40% is the out-of-bag sample from the training data. Then there's a separate part of the data that's the validation data based on that partition indicator. Based on the probability of the event 1 or 0, it uses that to average across all 150 trees that it just grew, and then you have a single score for each observation in the data set. Wow, that was actually pretty darn fast to do that on a million records. I was able to talk my way through the whole thing. We might want to save some predictive models, some predictive values to the data set. If we click on Derive Predicted, it'll save the predictions as well as the probabilities. Click OK on that. And now you can see that those have been added to the data set, along with some other stuff that I did in another video about cluster analysis. So you can see we've got from our forest, we've got the derived predicted probability and a prediction cutoff. You can play with all of these if you want to. I'm also going to show you how to do this same kind of a model using Model Studio. So I have already opened up Model Studio, and by the way, if you notice this little orange thing down here, that indicates that I'm actually using Viya for Learners. Viya for Learners is a computing environment that's free for students and for professors to learn how to use SAS Viya. And if you happen to have access to Viya for Learners, you'll see that little orange thing down at the bottom. It sends you to some additional help in the communities and places to ask questions. Anyway, it's the same Model Studio that you would have if you were using Viya, say, for example, in a large bank. What I've done is I've used one of the templates that's in Model Studio. That template is the intermediate template for a class target. And I've pre-run it here. So we've got a stepwise logistic that had some pre-processing earlier in it, and a forward logistic regression, and a decision tree. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add to this pipeline, I'm also going to add a random forest model or a forest model. So click forest, drag it right on top of data. And now it's been added in as a forest model. Now you can see what some of the settings are for the forest. The default is 100 trees. I'll go ahead and leave that default setting. And the default class target voting method in this case is probability. You'll recall that it was misclassification when we were using visual analytics. There are options for tree splitting that you can use just like you've seen before. You can change to using different class target criteria and interval target criteria and so on. I'm going to go ahead and leave these settings just the way they are, and I can click run right here, although this is where I get to feel a little bit like I'm on a cooking show because I have a pre-cooked pipeline that I've already run that has the results completed for me right there. One thing we want to look at, of course, is the results from the forest itself. What did this forest find? What were the trees in the forest like? First of all, does it look like it converged on a nice average squared error after 100 trees? And it does. It looks like it levels off pretty well after about 50. We can look at the misclassification rate as well and see that it does seem to level off. We have our in-bag, out-of-bag, which both come from the training data, and our validation data here. We have our, here we go, our variable importance table. The variable importance table is really useful because it's, depending on how many times a variable shows up as a split variable across all 100 of those trees, that could be a very, very important variable for being able to predict the target using that forest. Sometimes forests are referred to as black box models, and don't get me wrong, you're not going to sit there and read through all the Boolean rules to understand the if-thens that go into a random forest. But there are definitely some really nice diagnostics and tools for making them interpretable. The first of which, of course, is the variable importance table. So we have the variables that are most important for making our predictions. We have our output variables that have been scored. What I really want to do next is take a look at the comparison of the models, because we had four models that went into a tournament here. Now it's time to look at the results from the model comparison. Which one performed best? In this case, the one that performed best is still our stepwise logistic regression. So if you ran that intermediate flow, that intermediate pipeline, you would have selected the stepwise logistic regression. It's still being selected here based on the KS statistic. So maybe I can do a little bit better with this forest by playing around with some of the settings. And to do that, I would go in here, change the number of trees, change the tree splitting method, and of course, try auto-tuning. Auto-tuning does take significant time, but it's a way to try to find the best values for things like maximum depth, number of trees, the proportion for bootstrap sampling, and so forth. So lots of good stuff that I can do here, but I'll save that for you to play with on your own. So if you want to see more videos like this one, be sure you subscribe to the SAS Users channel right here. Check out some of the links down below under there. And if you like this video, please click like so that we know what kind of videos you're enjoying. Also, leave me a comment. Do you have any questions, anything like that? I'd love to hear from you. Leave something in the comments down below. Thanks. Till next time.